Welcome to the 2024 Unidos U.S. Annual Capital Awards Dinner. You know, I have to confess that this is one of my favorite nights of the year. And for those of you who attended last year's Capital Awards celebration on Valentine's Day, I promise that I won't embarrass you again tonight by pulling out the kiss cam, although it was a big hit and I loved it. First and foremost, we're here to honor the work of our incredible awardees, but we should also celebrate the opportunity of just being together. I'm always inspired by so many people so dedicated to the service of others, and I'm just thrilled we could all be here together this evening, and we should never take that for granted. The people here tonight represent a large part of our community's leadership. And over the past year, we've faced a myriad of challenges together, from blunt force tactics at the border and on immigration, to attacks on DEI, and to democracy itself. And I could go on and on. It is a challenging time, and moments of inspiration seem to be in short supply these days. But I found one. Oddly enough, in a recent documentary about the nation's greatest pop and rock artists of 1985 coming together to sing We Are the World. I know there are many of you here tonight too young to remember it, or perhaps were not even born in 1985. I know, to them, Stevie Wonder, Tina Turner, doesn't mean anything, no. Anyhow, while it was interesting to see all those many stars gathering together in one place for one night, I was especially moved by the central role Harry Belafonte played in driving the project as a way to raise money to combat famine in Africa. At the time, nearly a million people were dying in Ethiopia and other parts of Africa due to the drought and civil war. It was an overwhelming problem with no clear solution. As an artist and civil rights leader, Harry Belafonte had the unique stature and commitment to bring celebrated artists together to offer one solution to the problem. Together, they raised what would be, in today's dollars, $200 million for hunger relief in Africa. And at the time, Harry Belafonte said this, "The collective power of artists can be very impacting if we all put our egos aside in the service of people in the world who are less fortunate. We're truly all one people. We are in need of each other." He said, "I take it one at a time. If we can feed one person, we can feed a million. The point is to get in. The point is to get in." Watching the documentary, I found his words compelling and a forceful reminder of what we can achieve if we all get in. But while he was talking about hunger, his words and his life's example apply to so much more. From his earliest days as an artist, he was a champion of civil rights and a close associate of Dr. King. Throughout his career, Harry Belafonte fought tirelessly for social justice, equity, and inclusion, work we are engaged in defending today. Given his work on hunger, I found it somewhat appropriate that an awardee we celebrate tonight is one of our partners working on food insecurity and hunger, FRAC. Hunger is a critical issue for our community. A full 16% of Latino households experience food insecurity. Since 2006, we've been working with groups like FRAC to help those in need gain access to governmental programs that help women, infants, and children. When we started, only 41% of eligible Latinas received benefits to buy healthy foods they otherwise couldn't afford, like fruits and vegetables and even infant formula. Today, that number is 58%. This year alone, we helped over 2.7 million Hispanic mothers, infants, and toddlers receive the food they need to thrive. This is just one solution. But like Harry Belafonte said, if we can save one family, we can save a million. It is disheartening that the progress he championed on equity and inclusion during the civil rights era is being challenged in the present day. The recent Supreme Court decision on admissions and extremist challenges to DEI efforts in corporate America are threats to the progress we've made ensuring that people of color have upward mobility and are represented in every part of our society. Attacks like this aren't new. It seems like every time we try to make progress, there are some people who try to hold us back. And whether it's anti-Black Lives Matter, anti-woke, or anti-DEI, the fact is, whatever they call it, there are people ready to attack any effort at reconciling our diverse nation. I think they're really trying to just stop change. They think they're stopping us. But what they're really doing is holding back the whole country and our potential as a nation. We shouldn't have to justify these policies. The evidence of their success is all around us. Diversity, equity, and inclusion have been good for business, good for the marketplace, good for government, and I think it teaches us tolerance and acceptance at a time when we need to lean into those values. We need to learn to live with each other. We need to learn how to coexist. Opening the American dream to everyone is not only Unidos US's mission, but the foundation of a healthy society and a working democracy. One out of every four children born in this country is Hispanic. A child born today will be going to college in a multiracial and multiethnic nation. It's in everyone's interest that these children be healthy and have the tools and the access necessary for them to succeed, compete, and flourish in our global economy. Each of us needs to get in and embrace diversity as our superpower. As you all know, tonight is Super Tuesday. The stakes in the 2024 election for our community and our democracy couldn't be higher. We're going to do our part. Over the past decade, Unidos US has registered nearly a million Latino voters, educated them about the issues at stake, and helped to mobilize them on Election Day. We're going to be doing the same thing this year. We saw a 30% increase of Latino voters from 2016 to 2020. 20% of Hispanic voters will be first-time voters in this presidential election. But will it be enough? I believe each of us needs to get in somehow. What will you do besides voting? Will you get a family member or friend to vote? Will you be a poll watcher? Maybe you'll volunteer or donate to a campaign. Will you run for office? If we want our mothers and infants and toddlers to have enough healthy food to eat, you're going to have to get in. If we want our children properly educated and our workers able to get the kind of jobs that allow our families to own their own home, you're going to have to get in. We want a safe and secure border. If we're finally going to get relief for our long-settled, undocumented, including Dreamers, we have to get in. For too long, we've said we need Congress to act. For too long, we said we need Congress to act. What we need is to finally elect a Congress that will act. We have that power. And we need to choose a president who will reflect our values and priorities. You know, Dr. King once said that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. He didn't say that the arc would bend by itself. We all have to get in. We have to be our own champions. We have to be the voice of our generation. If each of us can move one person to vote, participate, and act, we can move millions. We can be the difference that tips the balance in this election. It's our time. Get in. Gracias.